A sort of maroon, Siena in the home whites. Ogunyemi will jump it up with Norval Carey. Both teams into the game 4-3 in the MAC. Ryder wins the opening tip and will go on offense, moving it left to right. Carey into the lane and lays it in easily.
Well, the Saints aren't going to be able to flop against that move right there, but that's a strong play right out of the gate. First possession, Ryder going right at Brett Bisping, who's been on fire, and kills Ryder, averaging a double-double.
Wright missed it, and it's rebounded by Khalil Thomas, the senior, tied for second in the MAC and rebounding with Bisping. Man-to-man D to start the game here for Siena. Jordan, step back two, rattles it home.
The only freshman in the starting lineup for either team, but for Ryder, Jordan has won the MAC Rookie of the Week 3 times this season, starts the game off well for himself.
Both teams start 4 seniors. These are 2 of the most experienced teams in the league.
In the country.
Right. Long the board, and he puts it in.
Levon Long with a really nice cross-court pass to an open Marquise Wright. He didn't rest, crashes the board. That is Levon Long to a T. The senior just makes a lot of hustle plays.
Carey backs in Bisping. Out of bounds to Ryder.
You think the game plan for Ryder is to go inside early? They are going right at this front line of the Saints.
Ryder, led by head coach Kevin Baggett in his 5th season, 78-71, the 2015 MAC Coach of the Year. And has the Bronx off to a strong 11-7 start, although Ryder has lost 2 straight, as Tom said. Go back inside again. Carey bangs it home.
An awkward left-handed shot right there by Carey. Didn't elevate, but just had the touch to make that from about 4 feet.
Foul underneath, and it's going to be called, or some sort of clock malfunction, perhaps.
Yeah, we're going to go to
Jimmy Patsos, the head coach of the Saints, in his 4th season with Siena, clothed as always by Mark Thomas, men's apparel.
It's interesting. Kevin Baggett has been at Ryder for 12 years. He was the associate head coach under Don Harnum, who was the longtime head coach, now the athletic director at Ryder. So Coach Baggett, very familiar with the MAC. Jimmy Patsos, before Siena, was at Loyola. So these are 2 long-tenured coaches in this league.
They had the shot clock at 31, which is actually not possible because there's a 30-second shot clock now, so they turn it down to 26. That changed last year. That was a phenomenal rule change. Changing the shot clock from 35 to 30. Jordan steals the sloppy pass, goes one-on-one with Wright. Jordan to the basket, off glass and in. Four points.
Nice job of going right at Marquise Wright. Ryder has not been bashful in the early going. Really throwing punches right at the jaw of the Saints, and they have the early lead.
Bisping for 3. Well off the mark, rebounded by Jordan.
Brett Bisping did not miss in the pregame.
Bangs at home, Jimmy Taylor. Huge start for the Bronx. 11-2, right out of the gate.
Well, we highlighted Jimmy Taylor in the pregame. Saw him making some threes in last year's contest in Albany. Last year, the Saints swept Ryder. Ryder is going for the sweep this year against the Saints.
Khalil Richard, freshman from Baltimore, checks in for Kadeem Smithen, who goes to the bench after that turnover. Ryder is not afraid of playing away from home. 7-5 on the road this year. Those 7 wins tie for the most true road wins in the country with 6 other teams. So not bashful about playing away from Alumni Gymnasium. 4 on the shot clock. Turnover.
4 on the shot clock, and tough to catch a pass at your ankles, especially when it's thrown that hard, that close. The Saints right now are a little bit disoriented, and Ryder is just on fire.
Almost a steal. It is stolen by Wright. He'll take it to the rack and score.
That's just an incredibly athletic play by a determined young man. You love to see that type of play to hopefully turn the momentum for the Saints.
Ryder is not a deep team. The Bronx really only play eight players. They maybe will add a ninth, but they only have nine players in uniform as the ball's knocked out of bounds to Siena. So any sort of foul trouble would really be problematic for the Bronx, but they've been doing this for the better part of a month now.
Well, if you ask Jim Boeheim, depth is overrated as his Syracuse team has turned it around, even though they ran into a buzzsaw last night. But Syracuse has turned it around, basically utilizing five or six, maybe seven players limited. So Ryder, with their experience and a very good freshman point guard, they're going to ride those players and just see if they can come up with victories. And thus far this season, they're 11-7. It's worked.
Xavier Lundy, the foul, his first. Unfortunate turnover for Siena.
Well, I mean, to be honest with you, that's about as careless a pass as you could possibly make in the game of basketball, almost mirroring a pass that LeVon made last game in a closer situation, end-of-game situation. So LeVon Long's got to simply value the basketball a little bit more than that. That is an assumption that cannot be made, and it led to a turnover.
As a result, Long and Wright go out of the game. Kadeem Smithen and Asante Shivers check back in.
This is a tough lineup for the Saints from a scoring standpoint. Simply, they just don't have a lot of scoring on the floor other than their front line.
Thomas, a senior, battling the senior Bisping, and he scores again.
And Brett is trying to draw that foul, and he's not getting it. He's going to have to hold his ground, and hopefully they don't call the foul where he gets hit in the chest and his arms come over the top of the offensive player.
Ryder with 8 points in the paint already as Okanyemi banks it in. Boy, neither team shooting jumpers. Everybody's going right to the goal.
1 3-point made field goal by Ryder in this game. Jimmy Taylor, that's it. Everything else really in the paint.
Taylor, short feed for Thomas, makes the nice catch. Rebounded on the weak side nicely by Richard.
You love guard rebounds, especially it helps you in transition.
Shivers drives to the rim and draws the foul. Goes down hard after a good foul by Jordan, and that'll send us to a timeout. Ryder got off to a quick 11-2 start. Saints trying to right the ship. Down by seven early here in Albany.
Ryder in the early going, shooting 6 of 9 from the field. 1 for 1 from downtown. Only one turnover. Siena with 3 turnovers in the early going. That's what has helped Ryder get off to this big start. Plus, Ryder just sticking to the game plan, going inside right at the front line of the Saints.
Yet to draw any fouls, but several easy baskets for the Bronx as Siena falls into a 2-3 zone. Jordan pounds the ball into the floor. Ryder recognizes, now looks to attack with 15 on the shot clock. Same five on the floor for the Bronx, not surprising. 3 from the corner for Jimmy Taylor, it's good.
Taylor is 2 for 2 from downtown.
And a Siena timeout. Interesting that Ryder's made their first 2 3-pointers. These are two of the worst 3-point shooting teams in the entire country. Ryder's at 30%, Siena's at 28%, which is in the bottom 5 in the whole country. Out of 350 teams.
Yeah, it's not a weapon that either of these teams utilize. And, you know, these teams right now, let's face it, their RPIs are in the lower 100s, so they're not knocking off those bigger foes in the non-conference. Simply put, at the mid-major level, if you do not have a 3-point attack, you will not win those games. So that's why these two teams, although Ryder with the better record, 11-7, just don't have that signature non-conference victory. And the 3-point shooting is a huge part of it. Don't make any mistake about it. If you're a mid-major and you don't shoot the 3-ball, you're not knocking off those teams, simply because you're not going to out-rebound them or not turn the ball over less than they do.
Not only are they the two worst percentage teams, kind of correlation, they both are the two lowest terms of three-pointers made per game.
Yeah, just over 4 for each team. Ryder just slightly better than the Saints.
10 on the shot clock. Ryder has started hot. Marquise Wright back in the game. 4 to shoot. Bisping desperately for Shivers at the shot clock buzzer. And it's rebounded by Xavier Lundy. Jordan on the run, 2-on-2. Jordan, right elbow jumper. Follow jam, Khalil Thomas.
Wow, the Saints got lucky right there. Well, Thomas had the follow-up, but The Siena defense just kept retreating and gave a very good freshman a wide open 15-foot jump shot there. And of course, Thomas makes a payoff with the left.
Smithen, the nice finish. Kadeem's been playing more and more of late. 6 points, five rebounds against Fairfield last time out.
Smithen is one of those guys that makes tough shots. He doesn't necessarily make the traditional shots. He's not a pull-up jump shooter. He's not a three-point shooter. But going to the basket, he'll make some left-handed runners. He'll make that tough right-handed shot.
Thomas travels. Evan Fisher into the game along with LaVon Long for Bisping and Shivers. Evan Fisher had been not playing a whole lot of late, but came in and played 9 minutes against Fairfield and contributed. Hit a three-pointer and also had five rebounds.
Yeah, the five rebounds were big because Evan's been struggling to rebound his position this year and be a defensive presence. So he came into the game and got it done defensively, and it's amazing how that affects your offensive game. He knocked down his only attempt, and it was a wide-open one. It was one the Saints definitely needed.
Nice pass to Long. Gets his own rebound. Ogunyemi crashing the glass. Flossing in.
Good job of crashing the boards for the Saints. Points in the paint again for Siena.
Both teams with 10 points in the paint already. Taylor steps into a three. Fight for the board, and there's a foul against Ryder.
And a good job of boxing out by Evan Fisher. He wasn't able to box out and then elevate to go get that rebound, so the Saints got the foul that they wanted. They want that attention because right now Ryder really getting it done in the paint against Siena.
Foul was called against Thomas, his first.
And Thomas just had the dunk in transition on the putback, so Siena definitely wants to get those over-the-back calls and keep the Bronx off the glass.
Ryder falls back into a 2-3 zone. Fisher rattles home the corner three.
Big basket for the sophomore. Set play against the zone defense. Double screen along the baseline. Good job of executing by the Saints.
Evan just 4 out of 21 from three-point range this year, but has made 2 in the last 2 games. Thomas, the possible three-point play.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, right now, Siena's just getting beat up on the glass. Javion Ogunyemi, the 6'10" senior for the Saints, really is not having a good season on the defensive glass, and right there, Thomas just manhandling him. Looking for the three-point play.
Thomas is not a good free throw shooter. 57%, the senior from Parkway, Florida. Preseason second team, all-MAC selection. A couple of subs, the first of the game for Ryder, Anthony Durham, along with Tyre Marshall, as Thomas looks good on that free throw.
Everything going the Bronx way right now.
20 points, 21 points in 7.5 minutes. Torrid pace Ryder setting.
It's exactly what you need if you're on the road in conference play. Victories are so hard to come by. You need to get off to a good start, and that's what Ryder has done against the Saints.
Siena scoring at a good clip too, 14 points in that same time span, but down by a touchdown here early.
Especially given last game against Fairfield, that was a game that really got off to a slow start from a scoring standpoint.
Saints still outside the arc with 5 to shoot. Smithen down the lane, lays it up. And it's rebounded by Stevie Jordan, who's been all around the ball. Jordan kicks it out for Taylor. Ryder will reset.
Saints are in zone defense.
Thomas couldn't get the roll. Rebounded by Fisher. Fisher playing well in his limited minutes off the bench so far.
Well, he's playing with a great deal of energy. It's amazing what getting a rebound and making a shot will do to your psyche on the court. He is showing that type of energy.
Right, the open three, banks it home.
Love the inside out passing, senior to senior. Marquise Wright picking it up.
He's got 5 points, pulls the Saints within 4.
It's funny, there's been games where the Saints felt they just needed to continue to score with their opponent. That wasn't set against Ryder, but it seems like that's how the game is going to go.
Thomas, not known as much of a jump shooter, he's already got 9 points.
And that was a shot that was partially blocked on the way up.
Wright forcing the issue. Thomas, good defense. Verticality. stood his ground, stood straight in the air, and Wright missed the shot.
I will say this, both coaches have to like the way the game is being called. Well, there's been more fouls on the Siena defensive end, but officials letting that go.
Foul is on Wright. It'll be his first. Ryder will go to the line when we return. Ryder up six early. Let's head over to Marissa.
Well, Robert, you and Tom were talking about Evan Fisher and the impact he's had so far. He's only played 3 minutes in this game, but has 3 points and a rebound already. And there was an interesting conversation between him and Jimmy Patsos in the last game where Coach Patsos turned to him and said, do you want to play? You used to play all the time. And Evan said, yeah, I do. Jimmy said, fine, go in, but you're going to do what I say. Go in there and get rebounds and play good defense. He did that. And then after he had three or four rebounds, he was open for a three. Jimmy said, shoot, pull the trigger. He knocked down the three. And already we see that from Evan Fisher. He's not necessarily looking for that three-pointer right away. In the one that he hit in this game, he was wide open, so he took it. I think part of the problem is the fact that in that exhibition game against Damon to start the season, he actually went 5 of 6 from three-point in that game. So Evan really wants to shoot the three, but Coach Patsos wants him to do all the other things. So if he does that, he's going to earn more playing time.
All right, thanks, Marissa, as Durham at the line makes the first. The foul was on Wright. Durham, a 64% free throw shooter, junior from Philly, at 5 points in 10 minutes against Siena in Ryder's 71-69 win back in early December down in Lawrenceville. Wrapping up the season series here today, unless the two teams meet again in the MAC tournament. Both teams tied for fourth place in the conference standings right now. Conference being led by Monmouth at 6-2. Sloppy turnover again. Saints have really struggled turning the ball over. Not really forced turnovers, kind of unforced errors. Marshall bangs it off the glass. Rebound comes away to Fisher.
Love those flat-footed rebounds. Evan Fisher picks up one.
Feed it down low for Bisping, who's yet to score. He flips it in.
And that's Brett's game. Loves to go off the left shoulder. And his compliment on this team is LaVon Long, who loves to go off the right shoulder, utilizing the left hand. So Brett gets an inside basket.
High scoring start here, just past the midway point, 25-19. Keelan Washington Ives is in the game for Ryder. Durham misses it. Marshall may have gone over the back. Carey throws it in our direction. Oh, they call it to Siena. Kevin Baggett can't believe it.
Well, we don't have to tell him, do we?
Secret safe with me. Wow.
Maybe it was apropos. The Saints wanted the over the back. They didn't get it. Letting the athletes play.
9.5 to go here in the first half.
Ryder knew the alley-oop was coming to Ogunyemi. They thwarted that.
Saints, to their credit, did not try to force it. And will run the offense. Down low for Javion. Wright, the floating three. He got it.
Good job of exchanging with Asante Shivers and Ogunyemi. Another inside-outside assist for Siena. Big man. Last time it was Bisping. This time, Ogunyemi.
Wright with 8 early. Washington Ives, not a huge scoring threat. And as we say that, he misses a shot, Bisping the rebound.
Saints got lucky, poor communication. They left the ball handler.
Secondary break, Wright feeling it. He checked there, it's rebounded by the Bronx, Jimmy Taylor. Taylor pulls up, way off the mark. Long rebound run down by Taylor. Awkward angle there for Shivers to try to get that board.
Well, right now, Ryder getting every 50-50 play. Those long rebounds are considered up for grabs, and Ryder's coming up with them, and that's been a big difference in this game. Just a step quicker in the early going.
Washington Ives woefully short on the runner, and a foul.
You know I love that shot. I think it's one of the worst shots in basketball, and I was proven correct right there again. Air ball goes to the Saints. A lot of times air balls fall in the hands of the offensive team. LaVon Long, great hustle to come up with that defensive rebound.
Tyre Marshall, the foul. He'll go to the bench along with Washington Ives. Thomas and Jordan back in. Saints trail by as much as 11 early in this game. Have not led.
18-7 they were down at one point.
LaVon gallops into the lane and was fouled.
Wow, that's a freight train that I'm not sure you would want to get in front of, Robert.
I know I wouldn't. Anthony Durham, the foul, his first. Just a tick over 8 minutes left to go.
Very close to a media timeout. Next stoppage in play, so the Saints are going to try to get a basket and continue to cut into this deficit. Since that 18-7 run, they're on a mini run of themselves, 15-7.
Xavier Lundy back in. He replaces what appears to be a bleeding Anthony Durham, who may have regrettably gotten in the way of LaVon Long there.
Yeah, see, it doesn't pay off.
Looks like he cut his lip.
Surprised they didn't go to the monitor.
Long knocks down the triple.
That's a huge shot for the Saints. LaVon Long, not known for and not successful at shooting the three, and he buries a big one to tie this game up.
It's only his third three-pointer of the season, and the Saints have come all the way back. Thomas showing the range. 11 points for Khalil Thomas.
Wow. He can make those shots, but he can't make foul shots.
That was not part of his game in years past. Coach Kevin Baggett said he really worked hard over the summer.
Well, he's a senior. He's smelling dollar figures, dollar signs.
Long. He got it.
No, he didn't. LaVon Long, back-to-back threes. We've never said that in his career.
8 points for LaVon. Saints take the lead, 28-27. Both teams scorching hot from beyond the arc as well. Who says these teams can't shoot three-pointers?
Last in the MAC. Not tonight.
Siena, 5 out of 8 from beyond the arc. Thomas is feeling it. He has 13. His average is 14.
He is just simply having his way with the Siena front line.
He is 6 out of 8 from the field. But the Saints going 3 for every Rider 2. Now it's Ogunyemi, stripped. Lundy, the loose ball. Jordan on the run, 3-on-3. Jordan accelerates, finger roll is up and in.
Wow, blew right past the defenders, the freshman, Stevie Jordan. We can see why he's been MAC Rookie of the Week 3 times. Transition basket after the turnover by this guy, Javian Ogunyemi.
Rams one off the backboard, rebounded by Thomas.
Another big traffic rebound by Thomas.
Lundy, the corner three, count it. These teams are on fire from beyond the arc. Ryder 3 for 3, Siena 5 out of 8.
7-0 run since the Saints took their one lead of the half by 1 point. Ryder right back.
Siena was 1 out of 19 from three-point range against Ryder down in Lawrenceville. Long is fouled by Thomas. It'll be his second, and it'll send us to a timeout after a long stretch without a stop in play. Ryder by 6. We touched on it earlier, how poor both these teams have been shooting the three this season, not tonight.
Last in the conference. Something that in the country they're ranked towards the bottom, but they come out firing tonight. Ryder started it with 2 in the early going, and the Saints simply have caught up. Marquise Wright with a few, Evan Fisher, and now LaVon Long back-to-back threes on possessions for the Saints. Huge buckets, and LaVon will be at the foul line right now. But the three-point weapon has not been something that either team has utilized, and tonight it's a different story.
LaVon 66% from the line this season. Good basketball so far from both of these teams. Both teams shooting over 50%, minimal turnovers since a sloppy start. And LaVon into double figures already, right at a season average with 10 points. We're here in Albany, New York. Robert Lee, Tom Herter, Marissa Jackson, our entire crew with you from the Times Union Center. We're Siena and Ryder battling here. Still relatively early in the MAC season. It's out of bounds off of Ryder.
I like the call right there. I'm not sure if it was actually off Jordan or not, could have been off Fisher, but with a player being out of control, if you're not going to call the player control charge, give the ball to the defense. Good call by the official right there.
Khalil Richard back in the game. Long's got the hot hand. Gets his own rebound. LaVon flips it up and in.
Simply just too strong for those players in the low post. LaVon is a mismatch nightmare, especially if Durham's going to be guarding them. And listen, Durham's no slouch. He's a strong young man. He's just simply not as strong as LaVon Long.
LaVon clapping his hands on defense and a foul. Is it on Wright? I think it will be. If it is, it'll be his second. No, it's on Ogunyemi. It's his second. So Javion with two fouls. Khalil Thomas also with two fouls.
Well, that's where the help defender is in good position. And when the help defender is 6'10", you don't need to spike the ball. Learn from Bill Russell. Oh, we saw it on the way up. He got him on the arm on the way up. It wasn't even at the top. It's a good call by the official.
If it was, though, on the way up, they do call it a shooting foul nonetheless. 73% for Jimmy Taylor from the line. He makes the first. Bisping in and Ogunyemi out. Thomas still in there with two fouls. As we said, Ryder really only plays eight players. So they'll leave players out there with two fouls in the first half. Jimmy Taylor's got 8 points. Full court press, stolen by Thomas. Another bad turnover for Siena.
Again, that's kind of a careless, lazy pass by Brett Bisping. LaVon Long was coming to the basketball.
Should be Ryder basketball. I mean, I thought that was pretty clear from here.
But to the ref's credit, he didn't see it. He looked for help and he got it.
It was clearly deflected out of bounds off of Siena. They'll keep the ball with 20 on the shot clock.
Sometimes you wish they could go to the monitor even before the last 2 minutes.
Somehow I'm glad they don't.
I agree, but you want them to get it right also.
Mm-hmm.
But those monitor checks late in the game, boy, they could take a long time.
Mm. Long three for Taylor. That was about a 30-footer and a foul on Marshall. That'll be his second. And that will...
Wow, that's a ticky-tack foul right there.
That will put Siena at the line for 1-1.
Good acting job right there by LaVon Long. He sold the call. Something tells me that wasn't enough contact to really knock him to the ground. He's stronger than that. But by exaggerating and accentuating that contact, LaVon Long will go to the line for one plus the bonus.
Tyre Marshall, his second foul. He's out of the game. Norville Carey back in. Thomas, another rebound.
Athletic, strong young man is Thomas.
Khalil 13 points and 5 boards already for Thomas.
Impressive first half.
Jordan, still 10 on the shot clock.
You can hear Coach Patsos over on the sidelines imploring his defenders, sit down, get low, get into a better defensive position.
Thomas tried to bank it in, rebound comes over to Durham. He's stuffed by Bisping. It's out of bounds to Ryder and a timeout. Close game here in Albany. Ryder leads it by 4 on Time Warner Cable Sports Channel. LaVon Long has started hot for Siena.
Well, right here, he gets himself going by getting on the glass. 3 offensive rebounds in the first half. And then he does something that's a little bit uncharacteristic. He knocks down the first 3 ball, and then, feeling disrespected, figures he'll knock down 2 in a row. And here we just see the strength and athleticism of a senior, strong player. LaVon Long grabbing the rebound in traffic, laying it in.
Open 3 from the corner is good for Stevie Jordan.
Off the baseline, out of bounds. Somehow, Ryder gets another open look.
Ryder is 4 out of 5 from beyond the arc. Long has 12 points, averages 10.5 a game this season. But Siena down by 7. They've trailed almost the entire game.
Ryder playing a zone defense.
Down to 5 to shoot, inside for Bisping.
Traveled.
He traveled. 7 turnovers against Siena.
going against the smaller Norville carry. Not a slouch of any stretch of the imagination, but just a shorter player. And Brett, instead of just laying it up on the strong side, tried to go weak side, got it. Call for the trap.
Thomas has been the hot hand. Takes Fisher towards the basket. Way off the mark. Long the rebound. LaVon running the floor. Secondary break here. Siena will reset. Richard flies down the lane and scores.
Great job of finishing Khalil Richard. He is a strong lead guard and able to get into traffic, into the chest of the defender, uses the weak hand, lays it in, big bucket for the Saints.
Jordan left alone for three. Way off. Right. The guard rebound. Right. Thought about it. Instead, nice touch pass for Long, who scores easily.
Great recognition as well. LaVon Long with another mismatch. Easy basket for the lefty.
14 for Long. Into double figures for the 10th time this season. Saints back within three. On fire. Khalil Thomas has 15 points.
He and LaVon Long are simply putting on a show.
Thomas has averaged just 14 a game. 15 already here before halftime.
High scoring game after a defensive effort by the Saints on the road at Fairfield, which was exceptional, one of their best of the season. And Ryder right now kind of doing a lot of what they want to do.
Richard, ill-advised shot, timeout, Ryder.
Use it or lose it. 30-second timeout by Ryder. Ryder up just by five.
It's certified public accountants, assist of the game, UHY, the network for doing business. Beautiful touch from Wright.
Yeah, it's a senior knowing how to put that touch on the pass. Marquise Wright obviously very comfortable on the floor, not worried about making mistakes, and he makes the great post-entry feed. That was a tough angle, so it was a very good pass by Marquise.
Both these teams in a real busy stretch in the schedule. Conference play, that's what you expect. Saints in a stretch of five games in 11 days. This is game number three in that stretch. Ryder playing its third game in 5 days.
Well, the good thing for Siena is a lot of those are at home, and you always like to play basketball this time of year because you're in good shape. You just want to roll out the games and get playing, and that's in the heat of the conference schedule. Both these teams are
too easy
to fight for victories. You're absolutely right. They break the pressure, do a good job of advancing the ball right on the out-of-bounds pass, and then Evan Fisher can do nothing but make sure there's no three-point play, and he did a pretty good job of that.
First foul on Fisher. Norville Carey, a 55% free throw shooter, graduate student from Southern Miss, originally from the British Virgin Islands, misses the first. Had a big game against Siena, 14 points, 13 rebounds. But he's been struggling of late, just 5 points a game over his last four. For the season, about 9.5 per game.
Well, it's funny, he's struggling of late, and Ryder went to him in two of their first three possessions to get him going. Went inside, and that's where Ryder was really kind of manhandling the front line of the Saints, scoring at will in the paint.
Has 5 points now. And on the shot clock, 45 seconds left in the first half. Ryder staying in that zone. Six to shoot. Bisping, right baseline jumper. Long volleys it to Okanyemi. He's fouled.
LaVon Long kept that possession alive for the Saints. Great job on the glass. Ryder playing some active defense. The Saints not getting a lot of good looks. That's a tough shot along the baseline by Brett Bisping to start this activity. And Javion Ogunyemi, like he does so well, getting on the offensive glass.
Boy, Khalil Thomas really went in there to block that shot. They called the foul on Taylor. Thomas has two fouls. Ogunyemi is really heated up from the line. He's up to 62%, and he makes the first. A couple big makes at the end of that Fairfield game.
Yeah, Javion's been a career 50% free throw shooter. So it's good to see the senior improving in that area.
Smoothly makes two. He's got six. He'll go out of the game with two fouls. Sammy Friday and Evan Fisher in for this final defensive possession. Bisping goes out as well. Like that substitution, get the guys who could be hurt by foul trouble out on what will probably be the last real relevant defensive possession of the half.
And the Saints only have four team fouls, so they could give a foul here just to...
Looks like Ryder's just going to run the clock down as far as they can.
5 second difference between the shot clock and game clock.
I got one coming out!
Durham pops free and pops the triple.
And Evan Fisher even yelled, I got one coming out, but he didn't get out to the shooter. That's a big three. Puts Ryder up seven.
Long charges towards the goal and scores again.
No surprise there.
16 for Long from three quarters court. Not in time. High scoring, entertaining first half. Ryder 45-40.
Big answer right there by Levon Long, the senior, because momentum swung in Ryder's favor. Seemed like they had most of the half. High scoring half. Saints did a good job keeping up.
Let's head over to Marissa with Coach.
Looking to go to 5-2.
And would be if they can win. Their third win in a row for the Peacocks would put them just a half game behind Monmouth. Monmouth, the preseason favorite pretty much by everybody, 6-2 in the league. They've kind of righted the ship. They've won four straight since an earlier loss to this Ryder team.
Yeah, exactly. It was kind of a surprise that they had two early losses. That Ryder victory in Lawrenceville. So Ryder's home court, 93-90 in overtime. So Ryder with a big surprise in the early going. But to your point, Monmouth has sort of righted the ship a little bit with four straight victories. No surprise there in first place, but I think the surprise was that they had two early season losses after last year rolling through the conference.
Also lost to St. Peter's, their other league loss. Saints with the four seniors plus Shivers out there in place of Smithen, four on the shot clock. Right. Long, just all over. Levon Long, 18-7.
Tell you what, Marquise Wright cannot get a call. He got some contact right there on the miss.
Turnover, Ryder. Levon Long has 18 points and 7 rebounds early in the second half.
He's just doing it all. You see the tipped pass by Levon Long. And the Saints right now, to me, they need to get Brett Bisping going. Brett, double-figure scorer, averages a double-double against this Ryder team in his career. Only 2 points, 1 of 3 in the first half.
Oh, Levon Long on fire! 21 points, a season high!
Well, at what point, if you're Ryder, do you start to worry about Levon Long from behind the arc? This is unprecedented. Levon Long has never made three-point field goals in the same game, and he's already at that point. Just feeling it.
Shivers the foul. Long came into the game 2 out of 9 from three-point range all season. Now, he did not play in every game, but for the season, he had 2 three-pointers. Tonight, he's 3 for 3.
Well, it's not like Ryder's daring him to shoot, but they're certainly not getting out on him contesting those three-point shots.
And he ties the game at 45. Long with 21. Not to be outdone. Thomas trying to answer. Thomas gets his own rebound. He's tied up. Jump ball. The arrow will favor Ryder.
Strong play right there by Levon Long. Just reaching up and tying up the equally strong Khalil Thomas. Two seniors battling. Help defender was Levon Long. Good job. But again, Khalil Thomas just doing some damage on the glass for Ryder.
His sixth board of the game. Not sure that pass was intended for Thomas. They do keep possession.
But he didn't drop it.
Jordan didn't want to shoot the three into traffic. Blocked by Bisping.
That is Brett Bisping's third block of the game.
Saints only led for 30 seconds in that first half. Could take the lead here. 2 minutes into the second. Can they get it to Long? Good ball movement here. They triple Ogunyemi, right the open three. Look who came away with the ball. It was Levon Long, a foul on Ryder.
Look who was held on the rebound.
Norval carry the foul, his first. Timeout. Yes.
And Kevin Baggett is right now not happy with the officiating. I mentioned before we went to break, Kevin Baggett not happy with the officiating. Levon Long getting tangled up with some players, and he was the benefit of those calls. So the Saints are going to continue to ride their senior.
Shivers.
Tough contested shot right there by Shivers. Khalil Thomas had great defensive position.
Saints turn it over after Long kept the rebound alive.
Saints scoring a lot off the offensive glass. They're not scoring a lot via the assist. We did mention in the first half, Stevie Jordan, four Ryder with six first half assists. The best for the Saints was just two by Marquise Wright.
Jordan second in the MAC in assists. Jordan to the basket, draws the foul. I think it'll be on Wright.
Boy, it's hard to breathe nowadays in college basketball.
The first half, it wasn't like that. Now the second half, everything's getting called. Yeah. Shivers out of the game along with Wright, and Richard and Smithen come in.
Well, mark this down.
Wright played 18 minutes in that first half. He has two fouls now, not really in foul trouble. Taylor guarded by Richard.
Thought that was his third. Glad it's not, but at the 17-17 mark, Marquise went out of the game.
Lundy pops the three. High arching shot, bypass the rim. Rebound knocked out of bounds with a block, I should say, off of Ryder.
Kadeem Smithen with the monster block. Boy, that was a bad air ball by Xavier Lundy.
He had a season-high 20 points against Siena in the season's first meeting. Long almost gave the ball away like a bull in a china shop to the basket, draws the foul.
Well, sometimes being lucky is good because Levon should have lost that basketball. I don't know if he was getting cute with the dribble, but he definitely almost gave it up.
Lundy his second. He'll go out of the game. Durham in. Saints have really struggled with these inbounds passes today. A couple of bad turnovers. Get it in safely here with a fresh shot clock. Bisping on only 2 points in that first half. Averages 12 and a half.
Only three shot attempts.
This will be his fourth, and it's good.
Well, I said he made everything in warm-ups, especially from three, and Brett Bisping hits a big basket for the Saints, giving them their largest lead of the game.
8-0 run to start the second half. 10-0 going back to the end of the first half to take the lead. Riders yet to score this half. And haven't really been that close. Long reaching in on Thomas, who scores again.
Just so strong, soft touch by the senior. Khalil Thomas continues to do work in the paint for Ryder.
17 points for Thomas to lead the Bronx. Almost a turnover. 10 on the shot clock, pounded inside for Ogunyemi. Bisping the corner three, and rebounded by Durham.
Yeah, slightly on the move. That was the difference between a make or a miss right there for Brett Bisping. Fading a little bit in the corner. Man-to-man defense almost throughout for the Saints, and Riders played a lot of zone defense.
10 to shoot here. Carey gingerly in on Ogunyemi. He flips it in.
Wow, he just dove through his chest, through his shoulder, into the chest of the defender, and just threw up the left-handed shot. No call, but Carey gets another basket.
Ryder takes the lead. 15 minutes to go. Richard hit a couple of shots against Fairfield on Sunday. Long. Rebounded by Jordan. 3-on-2 break. Jordan attacks the rim. Durham fumbled it sloppily out of bounds.
Ran into his own player.
Saints dodge a bullet there on the odd man rush. 14:39 to go. Saints trail by one. Good announcer's name, too. Not exactly your regular Joe Smith. Roman Penn, I like that.
Easy to say. A little bit different.
Will he be mightier than the sword? Foul. It's called on Carey. It's his second. Ryder, third foul of the half. Ryder with a one-point lead. Both teams come in 4-3 in the MAC. The winner will move into a tie for third place with Canisius. And just one game behind first place Monmouth. Right back in the game with 12 on the shot clock.
Canisius a little bit of a surprise, being coached by Reggie Witherspoon, doing some great work. The former University of Buffalo coach, and Brett Bisping hits his second three-point field goal of the half.
Simply cannot leave him open like that. 37% from beyond the arc. Best on the team. He's got 8 points. Saints take the lead.
Zone defense for the Bronx, and simply put, the Saints are just trying to score to keep up because Ryder is scoring fairly often on their own.
Although not as much here in the second half. 45 points in the first half. Oganyemi rejects Thomas. Long on the run out, one-on-one. Nice bounce pass to Wright, and he's fouled hard. Good foul by Ryder. Will send Wright to the line.
And I think Marquise Wright was looking at the officials almost incredulously, thinking, you weren't going to blow the whistle on that contact. The Siena bench wants them to review this, make sure it's not a flagrant.
Good basketball play, I think, going for the ball there at a minimum.
Yeah, that would be hard to find anything bad with that. As we see another angle. Yeah, he's definitely going for the ball. I'll tell you what, Steven Jordan is an athletic young man. The freshman got up for that.
See what the call is here.
And I'm a little surprised, given your stature, that they did not come over and explain to you that there was no need for a flagrant.
Don't
call.
They know who you are?
I was thinking that they don't know who you are.
Yeah.
You must be.
They always say it to you whenever they come over, as Marquise missed the first.
Yeah, but that's because before the game, I tell them you don't like them. They just talk to me.
Don't tell them. It's only certain ones.
You wouldn't believe how much he badmouths you do.
Right, one out of two, he has 9 points.
Is your family watching in Syracuse? I hope not.
52-49. Saints have matched their biggest lead of the game, 3 points. Ryder led by 11 early, but it's been pretty much Ryder leading by between about 4 and 6 points for most of the game. Bisping sloppy foul, his first.
Yeah, sloppy. You don't need to go for that. You're not in position to get that, Brett. Brett fouled out of a few games this season. They can ill afford to lose him in this game. This is going to be a high-scoring game. They're going to need everything out of their fifth-year senior, Brett Bisping. Can't afford those type of fouls. Careless.
Keelan Washington Ives, who made a cameo for 3 minutes in that first half, is back in there as long fouls. Jordan, it's Levant's first. Nobody on Siena has more than two fouls, so nobody in foul trouble. In fact, there's nobody in the game with more than two fouls.
Yeah, got him with the foot, tripped him.
Ryder is only 4 points in 7 minutes this half. Saints on a 12-4 run to start the half. Thomas trying to change that, kicks it out for a Taylor. Corner three, rebounded by Bisping.
He is such a greedy rebounder. Tries to get every single one. Brett Bisping, another defensive rebound.
Tied with Thomas for second in the MAC in that category behind Fairfield's Amadou Sidibe. Long attacks the rim. Awkward shot. Draws the foul. He'll go to the line.
A lot of red jerseys around LaVon Long on that dribble drive. I counted four of them. Able to get the shot off.
Taylor is now the sixth Ryder player with two fouls. As we said, nobody really in foul trouble with three, with about 12 and a half minutes to go. Long to the line. He's two out of three.
Players with lesser strength would simply not be able to, one, make that move, but then, two, they wouldn't be able to draw the foul. And LaVon, just with his sheer strength, able to slice through multiple layers of defense and just draw contact.
Lundy in for Thomas, who will get a quick breather with a media timeout coming up. Levon Long has more than doubled his season average. He has 23 points, two short of a career high.
14-4 run right now to start this second half.
Jordan, three-pointer. Way off the mark, right the rebound. Saints starting to open up this lead, up to 5 points now. Taking control here in the second half. Looking to win their fourth in a row. Inside for Ogunyemi, has Bisping wide open for three. Bang, Brett Bisping, third three of the second half. Saints have opened up an 8-point lead and a Rider timeout.
Love the recognition by Javion Ogunyemi. His teammates talked to him. They told him double team was coming along the baseline. Javion with the cross court skip to his senior teammate. Bisping's third three of the half. The Saints with their biggest lead of the game. And that's just pure right there. If you're Brett Bisping, that felt like butter.
This will be a media timeout because it came within 30 seconds of the 12-minute mark. Brett Bisping up to 11. Saints have opened up an 8-point lead on a 17-4 run to start the second half.
Hard to win on the road. This Siena team, only one victory on the season on the road. That was last game against Fairfield.
Ryder has 4 points in 8 minutes this half. We'll come out with Jordan, Taylor, Lundy, Washington, Ives, and Marshall. Thomas, their leading scorer tonight, is on the bench. Washington, Ives, still off the mark. Right the strong weak side rebound. Marquise on the run, 1-on-3. To Long, galloping to the rim. Nice lead for Bisping. He's in trouble down low, and Siena will reset, and a foul on Marshall. Nickel dimer on Tyre Marshall. His third, that'll be the sixth against Ryder as Thomas comes back in. As does Carey, out of the game, Washington Ives, who is 0 for 3 from the field, and Marshall will check out as well.
Nice unselfish play right there by Levon Long in traffic, in transition, because it looked like that shot was going to get punched by Khalil Thomas. Saints retain possession.
Foul will put Long at the line. Xavier Lundy, his third. And Levon Long to the free throw line for 1-1 with a chance to tie his career high.
Well, he missed the front end of the 1-1 in the first half. Let's see if he can capitalize in the second.
Into the game, Anthony Durham. Out of the game, Xavier Lundy, who has 3 points. Averages 11 a game. Long, 4 out of 5 from the line tonight, and 66% for the season. Third on the school's all-time scoring list coming in. As of now, needs about 60 more points to reach the top 30. He has tied a career high with 25 points, and the Saints have opened up a double-digit lead on a 19-4 run, 21-4 going back to the end of the first half.
Well, what's amazing is the Saints gave up 45 points in 20 minutes, and they've given up just 4 in a little over 8 minutes.
Thomas off the mark. Those shots not falling now. Siena pulling away right on the run.
Multiple white shirts around that defensive rebound. You love to see. The Saints have definitely picked it up at the defensive end.
One and done repeatedly. Right all alone in the corner. Defensive mix-up. I'm not sure Jordan knows what kind of defense they're in right now. Really running all over the place. Good patience. Right buries the three.
Unselfish play by Bisping. Great action by the Saints. Ryder simply gave up on Marquise Wright. He made the baseline post entry, and then they left him, and he was able to slide to the corner.
Quick shot by Carey. Ryder panicking here. Saints up 13.
Yeah, the wheels on the bus are falling off for Ryder. That's exactly what you don't want offensively, is the quick shot by a low percentage shooter.
22-4 in this second half. Ryder has only one timeout left. Right. Rebounded by Durham.
Same activity action for the Saints.
Steal by Wright. Feed to Ogunyemi. Javion to the rim. Missed the shot. He'll go to the line. Oh, missed the layup. Could have been a three-point play. He can't believe it.
Huge opportunity miss right there. The Saints, what a steal by Marquise Wright, reading that pass so perfectly in transition. Foul on Durham. Ogunyemi to the line.
Ryder has now given up a 15-0 run. Ogunyemi was 7. It was 49-48. It's now 63-49.
Ryder's last field goal was at the 15-15 mark. And again, this is a team that scored 45 points in the first half, and they have just 4 in 10 minutes in the second half.
14-point lead for Siena. And Ryder's just quick shooting the ball most times down the court and only getting one shot. Durham. Rebound comes away to Wright, ahead of the field, long off his hands, out of bounds.
Wow. Levon's got to watch some football and catch that with two hands. If he catches that with two hands, that's an easy basket for the Saints. Possible three-point play. And Khalil Thomas continues to give Javion Ogunyemi fits on the glass. Javion with just one defensive rebound. And on the defensive end, he is not venturing outside the paint. Saints really need him to get some defensive rebounds. But Thomas is just too athletic, too strong tonight.
Ryder on a 6-minute scoring drought. Can't end it there. Long rips away the rebound. His ninth. Saints really looking for the knockout blow here over the next minute or two.
And who do the Bronx go to? They have just abandoned looking for Khalil Thomas or Jimmy Taylor or Xavier Lundy and Stevie Jordan. Those are four guys who average double figures, and those players have just simply disappeared in this half.
Three to shoot. Bisping all alone for three. Rebounded by Thomas. Two on one. Ryder has to convert here. And they will. Anthony Durham has 6.
Transition opportunity after the errant three-point field goal. It was a good shot by Bisping. In fact, Ryder double-teamed the basketball and left Bisping open, so you can live with those. Brett just missed it.
Can't take the foot off the gas pedal yet. Siena up a dozen. Fisher in the game. Long double team. Long is fouled. He'll go to the line. Kevin Baggett does not look pleased. Tyre Marshall's fourth foul.
Well, when your team is reeling like this, you need every type of break, and you can't afford to have those type of fouls. Ryder just came off one of their few stops of the second half where they were able to get out in transition and score, and then they allow Siena to get back to the line where, make or miss, Siena's going to be able to set up their defense at the other end.
1-1 here. Long unable to set a new career high. Not over yet, 12-point game. Jordan probing the lane. Durham pull-up jumper. Rebounded by Taylor. Awkwardly. Durham foot on the line jumper. Continues to fire away. Another opportunity here for Ryder. He's out of bounds. He's out of bounds. Jimmy Taylor. Can't believe it. He's been around the block a few times. 7:41 to go. Saints by a dozen here in Albany. Saints have opened up a 12-point lead on the back of very strong three-point shooting.
Saints 10 for 18. Levon Long is 3 for 4. Marquise Wright is 3 for 6. Brett Bisping 3 for 6. Evan Fisher 1 for 1. That is simply not a weapon the Saints have utilized often this season.
10 out of 18, 56% from beyond the arc, just 51% from the field, so actually shooting better from three-point range than from inside the arc. But a winning recipe so far, including 5 of 10 here in the second half.
Levon Long continues to just score and rebound and hustle. 25 points, 9 rebounds. Brett Bisping into double figures with 11. And after the Thomas heel on the out-of-bounds line, if it was that, the Ryder bench didn't think so, but the Saints will get possession.
Full court press. Ogunyemi tried to trap him. Saints get it into the offensive end with 20 on the shot clock.
Good patience right there by two seniors. Judiciously breaking that trapping full court press.
Saints come in, winners of 3 straight. Ryder has lost 2 in a row. Ogunyemi, awkward left-handed shot. Got the roll.
Somehow that ball fell. Saints get another basket, executing. They reverse the floor offensively and go inside to their senior.
Foul on Bisping. Be remiss if we did not mention that Brett is into the top 20 on the school's all-time scoring list. He's actually passed a couple other players tonight, Evan Himes for 18th, and then he's actually tied Steve Walters, class of 76, for 17th with 1,346 points. Another great note they had in the game notes. Brett Bisping had a 4.0 GPA in the fall semester. Cheers to you, Brett Bisping.
Nice effort.
Thomas rejected by Ogunyemi. Shivers the loose ball.
Great defense. Two upperclassmen going head-to-head. No foul called. Contact because of the offensive move. Good job by the officials not making that call, but a great job defensively by Bisping.
Brett's all alone. Thomas
somehow goes to his right hand when the left hand looked like it would have been better use.
Nice pass there from Jordan for the easy bucket by Durham.
I think
8
Brett
points.
Has 2 misses in the second half, and both times Ryder scored in transition after the miss.
Full court press, kind of a frantic sequence now. Ogunyemi running the break to Bisping, rejected by Thomas, a jump ball. Athletic play by Khalil Thomas.
Yeah, that's just two big bodies going up, meeting at the top, and Thomas had the better and upper hand.
17 points, 8 rebounds for Thomas as he just denies Brett Bisping on the layup attempt.
It's a great job defensively.
Saints do keep the ball with the arrow. 6 minutes to go. 12-point lead.
Ryder stays in the zone defense. Down 12, under 6 minutes to go. Siena shooting the way they are.
Double team on Ogunyemi. Forces his way to the basket and draws the foul. I think Tyre Marshall just fouled out of the game. No, it's on Thomas. It's his third.
Saints are going to Ogunyemi a lot as of late. I believe he's got 9 points right now. He'll try to get into double figures. Would be the 4th Siena player in double figures. And oh, by the way, they're all 4 seniors.
So what Coach Patsosa said, he's going to rely on those 4 guys the rest of the way. As Ogunyemi now 4 out of 5 from the line. All 1,000-point scorers. The only team in the country with 4,000-point scorers. Ogunyemi, the least points of the quartet. But doing something to change that with 2 made free throws. He's got 11. Shivers out, Fisher in. Saints with a big, big lineup here. And a 14-point lead. We're talking 3 guys at 6'7" or tall, 4 guys, 6'7" or taller out there. In theory, Long could be the shooting guard right now. Thomas scored in a foul, 19 for Khalil Thomas.
I think that's going to be on Ogunyemi from behind the help defender. Thomas is a handful, Javion's 3rd foul. Good position defense right there by Evan Fisher, but he took the blow. Doesn't elevate, but the defender from behind gets called for the foul. And to your point, Siena with one of their biggest lineups of the season.
Thomas, every point so important now for the Bronx. Down by double figures as the high arching free throw is good. He's into 20-point territory for the 4th time this season. 11-point lead.
Well, he's almost also close to getting a double-double, which he has 8 on the season.
Which leads the MAC. Flex offense look here. Fisher pops open. 6 to shoot. down to three. Wright kicks it out for Fisher. Three at the buzzer. Thomas double-double. No, they're going to credit him with nine rebounds right now. More importantly, Ryder on the run. Jordan missed the runner. Rebounded by Marshall and a foul. It's going to be four on Ogunyemi.
From behind again, that time on the defensive rebound. And I've mentioned this, Javion, just he is simply struggling at the defensive end to come up with rebounds to stop possessions for the opposing team. And he'll go to the bench with those four fouls. Siena's going to have to rebound down the stretch. Fisher, Bisping, Long, those guys are really going to have to do some damage on the defensive boards.
Tyre Marshall is 4 out of 15 from the free throw line this season, and he gets a very friendly roll. It's about 25%. But gets his first point of the game. Freshman from Philly had a good game against Siena, 8.6 rebounds. And against all odds, he makes two free throws. And cuts it to a single-digit lead, 9 points. Trapped in the corner, bad turnover by Wright. And a foul will put Ryder at the line. Just tried to throw it off of Thomas's leg and ended up throwing it right to him, and then he fouls Thomas.
Yeah, tough place to catch the ball if you're Marquise, shorter player against bigger defenders trapped in the corner. It's exactly where the Ryder trapping full court press wants Siena to catch the basketball. They want to get the ball to the middle of the floor. Thomas, who's been so good from the line, misses the front end of one of them.
Terribly missed there. Ball went about 15 feet in the air. It's worked for him earlier. Big miss, though, by Thomas. Ryder is the worst free throw shooting team in the league by quite a bit, 65%. 9-point lead. Long foul. Goes down hard. He'll have another chance to try to set a new career high.
That's a great job of LeVon Long. First of all, being strong enough to catch the ball in traffic. Second of all, being strong enough to force the issue. But really, what made the play was the youthfulness right there of Tyre Marshall. Just over the top of LeVon. Easy call for the officials at a crucial juncture for Ryder. Fifth foul for the freshman. But credit LeVon Long with just having the court savviness to make that play.
Ryder has 13 points this half. Career high for LeVon Long.
That's going to be the story.
Yep.
Tale of two halves. Ryder really came out firing. They came out with a lot of energy, knocked down. They were efficient. They didn't take a lot of threes in the first half, but they made them. They went inside, did the damage on the offensive glass. Thomas was just spectacular. And this second half has been all Siena.
Career high, 27 for Long. Carry in the lane, lays it in.
Good job of using his pivot foot to create some space.
If you're Ryder, you want to defend, but you want to stop fouling. Continue to put Siena at the line.
Ogunyemi back in the game for the Saints.
With four fouls. 4 minutes to go, Saints by nine, trying to salt this one away and win their season high fourth in a row. Good job by Taylor, keeping Long from getting the ball on the block. Now they're matched up one-on-one. Seniors, six to shoot. Ogunyemi with four. Double teamed. Carey's got it. Ryder chance to pull closer, down by nine. Taylor's all alone. Good rebound by Carey. Jordan didn't want to shoot it. Shows patience. Post-to-post pass. Thomas, almost a three-point play opportunity. He'll go to the line.
When we come back.
It's called on Fisher. Saints lead it by nine with 3:21 to go. Here on Time Warner. At St. Peter's, a place, I don't know the numbers, but Siena hasn't won at St. Peter's in a long time.
No, St. Peter's is a tough place to win, even for some of the best Siena teams.
Thomas struggling from the line. critical misses here as Ryder's down 9 with 3:20 to go. Robert Lee, Tom Herter, Marissa Jacks with you from the Times Union Center in Albany.
20 points, 9 rebounds for Khalil Thomas. Been extremely impressive. And LaVon Long just picked up his 10th rebound for his double-double, the second of his senior season.
And 8th of his career. Big misses by Thomas. Khalil Richard in the game here in crunch time. With the four seniors. 7 to shoot. Illegal screen on Bisping. Will not be a shooting foul, but it will be Brett's third. I think Ryder would rather not go to the free throw line at this point.
Well, the Saints do not have a field goal in over 4 minutes. They just have 4 foul shots. So someone's going to have to step up and make a field goal for the Saints if they want to pull out this victory. We'll see what Ryder looks to do against the man-to-man defense. Thomas going against Ogunyemi with 5.
Turnover by Taylor. Richard wisely pulls it out. Did not want to go towards the basket.
What part of you wanted him to pull up from 3 right there?
No part of me. No part of Jimmy Patsos either, I don't think. Bisping his 4th.
And that's back-to-back just mentally poor decisions right there by Brett Bisping. As a senior, he's got to know he didn't have the advantage when he curled on that pass, so you can't just lower your shoulder. Back-to-back offensive fouls for Bisping.
Saints really about 1 score away from putting this game away. They're keeping Ryder in the game.
It's a race to 72.
Score Steven for Jordan. He's got 11. Ryder has 1 timeout left. Saints have 3 if they get into trouble. 7-point lead, 2:10 to go. Ryder may look to start fouling.
Just thinking the same thing. At what point, if you're Ryder, do you start the foul?
Problem is they don't have a lot of players. Ogunyemi almost ferociously broke the rim in half. Instead, he'll go to the line. Whoa, pushing and shoving here. Not sure what happened there, and this is going to take a while to adjudicate. Kevin Baggett all the way at the other end of the court, having words with Marquise Wright. Kevin Baggett sprinted about 70 feet down the court. Kevin Baggett and Jimmy Patsos are barking at each other.
Well, Kevin Baggett can't talk to Marquise Wright, and that's what he's doing. I mean, whether he wants to fire up his own team or not, you don't sit there and start pointing out other players. Now, Marquise Wright pushed Jordan, the freshman. I'm sure that was some type of reaction to something. This is going to be ugly for both teams, quite frankly, because you know why? Everything is on tape nowadays. You can't get away with anything.
It looked to be a relatively innocuous play that turned into a Ryder player being shoved to the floor. And I wouldn't be surprised if not only there's technical fouls clearly coming here, but some sort of ejection. Marquise Wright clearly pushed Stevie Jordan to the floor, and then all heck kind of broke loose. The coaching staffs are trying to keep everyone cool, but Kevin Baggett made his way quickly down the court and started barking at the Siena senior guard. And I don't think Coach Patsos saw that until about right now. And then he and Baggett got into it.
With their cell phones, who happened to be quick to...
So you see Marquise Wright and Anthony Durham. Durham punched Marquise Wright there, but I think that's after Marquise Wright had pushed Jordan, but Anthony Durham punched Marquise Wright with his left hand.
Yeah, we got to, if we could, go back a little bit further to see what transpired on the initial foul, the initial interaction between Marquise Wright and Stevie Jordan, the freshman.
Look at LaVon Long, peacemaker.
I'd listen to him.
Very laid-back fellow.
Yeah.
So Ogunyemi gets up, is pushed by Marquise Wright. He trips over Ogunyemi's leg, but he was initially pushed by Marquise Wright. Then I think you'll be blocked by the stanchion here. Then Anthony Durham punches Marquise Wright with his left hand.
Yeah, I have no idea what set Marquise Wright off, to do that, but Marquise Wright it seems like he was the starter to that whole
It doesn't
incident.
Take Kevin Baggett very long to get into that picture. The view we had was better. As the officials continue to struggle with this, you see right there, that was the best view. Anthony Durham punched Marquise Wright with his left hand.
Yeah, what's unfortunate is what started the whole melee. I have no idea what Marquise Wright as a senior is doing, coming over, pushing Jordan. I don't know.
Now there is 2:03 left, and Siena leads it by 7. Ogunyemi, eventually, when this all plays out, is going to go to the line. But will there be more? So you see Jordan get pushed by Marquise right there. Marquise is, we're speculating here, but he'll probably pick up some sort of technical foul as well.
You have to. I mean, that's what started it. It's unfortunate on every level, actually.
Absolutely. Never want to see something like this. And then Kevin Baggett comes all the way down to the other end of the court, and he starts drawing it right, which is just not what you want to see.
I'll tell you what, to the credit of the official right there, he's at least in between, but it's not like he's taking Kevin Baggett and removing him from the situation.
And Coach Patsos was relatively calm until this point. I think he's saying Bags. Greg Dashnaw, the Siena trainer.
Greg Dashnaw, I know his cooler heads didn't prevail right there, but he's the only one telling Baggett to get back to his bench.
Because from my understanding, two technical fouls would immediately eject them from the game. The end result is Siena's up 7. Ryder now has only 7 players left eligible to play in the building. Offsetting technicals on Jordan and Richard as Ogunyemi, after about a 10-minute delay, misses the first.
And one of them I don't even think has entered the game thus far or taken his warm-up off.
Correct. Xavier Malone has not played. Now that will be a foul on Jordan, his third. Carey picked up his third. Richard not in foul trouble as Ogunyemi makes 1 out of 2.
After all that, we get 1 point.
Ryder down 8 with the ball. Tempers flaring here at the Times Union Center. Jordan pulls up for a long jumper. Rebounded by Carey. 1:40 to go. Still plenty of time here for Ryder. Thomas has had the big game. He's double teamed. Can't get the roll. Rebound somehow comes away to Jordan. Long possession for Ryder. Taylor will go to the line. Bisping has fouled out of the game.
Wow.
Bisping fouls out. 5 quick fouls on Bisping.
Well, I'll tell you what, this last 90 seconds cannot go quick enough for Siena, because one, they simply can't come up with a defensive rebound right now. Any missed shot is going to the Bronx. Khalil Thomas and Norval Carey are just killing the Saints on the glass.
Bisping out of the game now. Shivers checks in. And the rebounding certainly won't improve with Bisping out as Taylor makes the first.
Taylor just 2 for 9 from the field. 2 for 10 after the miss. Well, he got fouled, but he's been a little quiet tonight.
Makes 1 out of 2. 7-point lead, minute 20 to go. Does Ryder look to foul here? Smithen is an excellent free throw shooter. He traveled. His shoe slipped.
Well, his shoe slipped, but he was trying to make a play that was maybe possibly slightly out of control, tried to stop his momentum. He was avoiding contact from a player in front of him.
Both teams in the double bonus. Lundy, a big 3. Long the rebound. Saints will run 2-on-1, can run some time off the clock. It's Smithen laying it in. 9-point lead with a minute to go. Taylor forcing the issue.
No foul.
Gets his own rebound. Missed the shot. Fisher the board. Foul. Fisher. Fisher will go to the line with 45 seconds left.
Big rebounds by LaVon Long and then Evan Fisher right there. Ryder just, they've abandoned the three-point field goal tries when they're down by seven or nine. And they just can't buy a basket when they need it.
They have 18 points in the second half.
Too much time off the clock in the last couple minutes when you're really trying to make a frenetic comeback. And that will be the story. We talked about it. 45 points in the first half. 18 thus far in the second.
10-point lead for Siena. Fisher. Smooth from the line. Timeout, Siena. Fisher with 5 points. And these diehards who've shown up here tonight look like they'll be treated to what, frankly, should be a Siena win at this point with an 11-point lead and 45 seconds to go.
Boy, if it isn't, I hate to think of what's to come.
New Mexico thought that save was lead against Nevada.
If you thought that little altercation was interesting. If the Saints lose, this next 45 seconds will be even more interesting. Well, Ryder came in here looking for the sweep. They got off to the hot start. Really went right at the Saints. I think I even said early on, it looked like they punched him in the jaw. They put Siena on their heels. And to Siena's credit, behind LaVon Long, they just kept pace, scoring in the first half. And, boy, their defense was exceptional in the second half.
Ryder desperate, four possession game. If they don't score here, they'll probably not foul. Long digs out the rebound. Will Ryder foul? No, Siena will turn it over and Carey will attack the rim.
Lavaccia just threw that long.
9-point lead, 26 seconds left. Only took 2 seconds off the clock in about 20 seconds. Very important that this officiating crew make sure that no tempers flare here the rest of the way. The game pretty much in hand at this point.
Evan Fisher wanted no part of that.
Wisely. LaVon Long has scored a career high tonight, and he can extend that here. He has been brilliant. He's 8 out of 12 from the field. He's 8 out of 10 from the free throw line. He's made 3 three-pointers, more than he had made all season. He has 12 rebounds and now 27 points. T9 for Long. Final 20 seconds here. Saints by 11. Long three for Taylor. 12 for Jimmy Taylor. Ryder still has a timeout left if they want to use it. Instead, it's a throw ahead for Long with 18 seconds left. No reason to shoot here. And Siena will not. Oh, foul.
Well, Jimmy Taylor hit the first three-point field goal of the game for either team.
Timeout,
and
Ryder.
Mostly likely hit the last, and Ryder takes a timeout to see if they can figure out an 8 or 10-point play.
I think Kevin Baggett in the mood to agitate the remaining fans here by calling that timeout in an 8-point game.
Well, they know the MAC tournament's here. They just want to spend some more time on this floor.
And that will be the next time, if these two teams meet again, would be in the MAC tournament as the teams will split their season series. Each team winning on its home court. Short timeout, strategic discussion for Ryder. It's over. 10 seconds left.
Well, it looks like the Saints will get their fourth straight victory, continuing to try to right this ship of the season. Tough non-conference record, but they're starting to put some victories together in conference. 5-3 they should move to, which keeps pace with Canisius. So they go from being tied for fourth to tied for third.
And just one game out of first with 2 games remaining against that team in first, and they'll be only a half game behind St. Peter's, who they beat already and will play next. Two games with Monmouth, both in February. In fact, two of the Saints' final five games are against Monmouth. The teams picked 1-2 in the preseason poll.
Funny how that happens.
Three for Shivers. And a 10-point lead. Ryder one last try here as Jordan misses it. Oganyemi the rebound. Saints win 78-68 the final. Four wins in a row for the Saints.